Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Parmesan chicken. It's a dish that's really easy to make and I think you'll enjoy it. It tastes really good and it makes use of some convenience products. So it's really Americanized and some of you like those and some of you would rather see something that's more Italian. I do have some Italian recipes that are a little more authentic than this, but quite often I will just do something that is very easy by using Italian sauces and so on. So we'll start with the fresh chicken, and I'm using 4 chicken breast halves. You can see this is typically what a breast half will look like. But I started to pound one of them, and then I wanted to show you what it's like to do this pounding. I'm using a meat mallet, which is a tenderizer actually, and this will tenderize it as well as make it thinner. My goal is mainly to make it thinner so we will have the shape that is desirable for this dish. So I'm just going to try not to put holes in it, and I'm trying to flatten it out a bit. So I'll do maybe a little more on this one, but that's pretty much what you're after. You're wanting a complete piece of meat without holes in it. And when we have it like this, we'll be able to fry it in a skillet, and it'll only take about 3 or 4 minutes on each side. So that's an advantage that you have, but also it just tastes really good and crispy when you do it this way. So I'm going to continue on these, and I'll have all 4 done, and then we'll come back and continue on a recipe. I want to show you the 4 pieces of chicken breast. You can see how flat they are. They will have a tendency maybe to fall apart on you, but I think I did pretty well on these. So they're going to hang together pretty well, and we will be putting a coating on them. Now I would like to mention that you might have noticed that I had some scraps here. I always trim any chicken breast or any meat, well, I'll say almost always. I will trim it of any fat, gristle, anything that's undesirable. So I just put that on an extra plate that I will put aside. And I began all of this process by washing the chicken breast, with fresh water, and then I had them in this bowl and I had drained them, and I used paper toweling to pat them dry. And then I focused on getting them flattened and tenderized, and then I wash my hands. So now we're ready to put a coating together. I'm going to move this bowl. The coating will consist of some flour. We have 1/3 cup of all-purpose flour, and it really needs to be in a shallow dish or on a plate or something like that, because we'll have to dip these, and actually I'm going to have to let them curl up a little bit and move them across because this is kind of small, but I wanted to fit all of these on the counter. And then in the middle here I have 1 well-beaten egg. So we're going to dip into the flour, then into the egg, and then over here I'm going to make a little mixture which will have Italian breadcrumbs, 1/2 cup, and also some Parmesan cheese. And this has been freshly grated, smells really good, and that's the best kind to use. If you don't want to do the grating, you can buy it already grated, or maybe just shredded. It's not quite as good that way, but that will work. So just stir that around, and that's the 3rd thing that we will dip these into. So I'm going to hold off on this for a minute because I need to get my spaghetti started. Over here I have a pot that I have water about 1.5 inches, and I've left plenty of space for it to boil, because it will. I've salted the water. I just put this here to remind me to tell you I put 1 teaspoon of salt in there, and I have my spaghetti sitting here ready. This is 1 pound. I'll only need 1/2 of it, so I'll divide that in half, and when this boils, I will put it in. I won't put it in the cool water or while it's coming to a boil. So I think I'm going to have to wait a minute and then come right back. Now here is my 1 pound of spaghetti, and you know I just need the 8 ounces, so I'm just going to get an approximation here. Doesn't have to be perfect, but I'll just grab one of these out of the box and say that's 1/2. So it's approximately 8 ounces, and I usually break my spaghetti. I know a lot of you don't, but just go toward the center, give it a good crack, and put it in the salted water. Now it will stop boiling for a minute, but it will come back to a boil very quickly, and I'll keep my eye on it, and I will actually stir it around a little bit occasionally. But in the meantime, we need to get our chicken ready. So I'm going to move back to my workspace, and what I'm going to do is to season up the chicken. I'm going to use salt and pepper, and then those pans that we put out, those dishes with flour, and also egg, and also our coating mix. We're going to use those to coat our chicken. We'll be back over here where I have peanut oil, about 3 tablespoons, in a large cast iron skillet. You don't have to use cast iron, but it works really well. So back over here to the workspace, I'm just going to grind a little sea salt over these. Now, other parts of this recipe are salted, like the spaghetti and any pre-bottled sauce that I might put on. So I don't need a whole lot of salt. I like putting ground pepper, fresh ground pepper, on chicken. So I'm just doing one side here. You might notice, you can do both sides if you want to, but I'm getting it pretty thoroughly seasoned. So there we go with that, and I'm keeping an eye over here. It's doing fine. So next thing is to pick up one of these, and I want to put it in the flour and coat it on both sides, and you just need to turn it a few times. You don't want any edges or parts that don't get that flour into it. Even press it if you want to a little bit. Then go into the beaten egg and get all of that coated. And then go into your final coating, which is your Italian breadcrumbs mixed with Parmesan cheese that's been freshly grated. Isn't that a nice coating? Looks wonderful. You need some place to set this. So we'll just bring it out and put it on a platter. Now I'll continue with the others, and when I get ready to cook them on the stove, and I'll probably have to turn that off, but I'll turn it back on and have it ready for you when I come back. My spaghetti is done, and I've already drained it through this colander into the sink, so this is empty. Now this is al dente. It's a little on the yellow side, you can see, but this is going to be baked in the oven just a little bit, and it's gonna have some hot chicken breasts on top of it and some sauce that will be heated, so it can come up a little early, and then it gets poured into a baking pan, something that is oven proof. This is about 9.5 by 11 by 2 inches, something of that sort will be fine. Just put that in the bottom, and it's hot, and what we want to do is to manage to keep it hot while we do the rest of our preparation. So I have sprayed this cooking pan or dish, and I'm going to take some aluminum foil and put this over the top just to make sure that this stays warm while I fix the chicken. Now over here, I think this is hot. So what we're going to do is drop in a piece of chicken. Here we go. Into our hot peanut oil. Now I choose peanut oil because it has a high smoking point, and I don't want this to smoke while I'm busy doing something else. But this is just right for frying the chicken. And like I said earlier, it'll only take about 3 or 4 minutes per side because this is so thin. And I've chosen a very large skillet so that I would have plenty of space for them to all lie flat. When you have to lap them, that works, but it's just a little harder. It's going to take me a minute to get these done. Like I said, 3 or 4 minutes on a side. So I'll be back when these are done, and then we'll continue with our recipe. Our chicken is done. So what I'm going to do is remove it from the skillet and put it on paper toweling. Now I'll turn it over to just pat out any extra peanut oil that it might have soaked up. You can see from the paper towel that there will be a little bit. I'm going to turn this off and then get the rest of those. And since I take the time to drain these, I'm going to meet you on the other side of the counter in just a second. It just took a few minutes to get our chicken done. And I did drain it, like I was mentioning, so it's ready to go. And here we have our spaghetti that has had to sit only a few minutes, so it should be steaming hot still. And we're going to assemble our chicken parmesan. It needs an Italian sauce, and I like to use Prego. Some of you have written in and said you like some other brand, any brand that you like. If it says Italian sauce, or it could even be a pizza sauce or anything that is related. But this actually has 3 cups in it, and I'm taking 2 cups, and I put it in here just to demonstrate. Really, you could just pour 2/3 of this in, but I'm taking 2 cups, and I'm putting that over the top of our spaghetti. And if you want to take a spoon and smooth that out, you can. I didn't really bring a spoon, and I think I'm going to get by without it. But that looks good. On top of your sauce, you're going to put your pieces of chicken. So these are nice flat pieces, and I can use them to just spread out that sauce. And 4 of them will fit really well. And you might strategically place them so that the smaller ones will pair with the larger ones. And you'll have those 4 kind of making a covering of your sauce there. Now next we have the rest of the sauce, and there's not much, there's just 1 cup left, so I'll be a little more sparing as I pour this out. But we'll get it all eventually. Slow to come. But that's pretty much it. You couldn't get much more than that. And I'll take our tongs just to rake that across to get better coverage. You want it a thin little bit instead of just globs here and there. So something like this will be fine. Now, on top of that, I'm putting mozzarella cheese. And this is pre-shredded, so it was just bought shredded. If you like to get the blocks and shred those, that's really nice. But this is what I had in my refrigerator that needed to be used up. It's 1 cup's worth, so this is going on top. And then the whole thing is cooked. It's just that we put some sauce on that had not been heated, although with it touching the chicken and touching the noodles, it will warm up. What we're going to do is help it along a little bit. We're going to put it in the oven under the broiler. Actually, I'm going to put it toward the center of the oven, but I'm going to turn it to broil, and we'll let it cook from the top to get this nice and crusty and brown. So that's going to look very good, and I'll show you what it looks like in just a minute. Our chicken parmesan is done, and I want to just serve 1 piece out here onto a plate. And remember, there were 4 sections, so it's easiest to cut down where you know there are divisions. So this is a big piece. It's going to have some spaghetti there on the bottom that's stringing along. And here we go onto the plate, and there's our nice serving of chicken parmesan. If I could get loose from it. There we go. I hope you enjoy it. I wanted to show you what the chicken parmesan is like when you cut down through it. So I'll just cut down the center, let you see what it looks like. It's really tender, super tender, because we did all that pounding on it. And it's nice and white, as chicken breast should be. And I'm going to just take my knife and cut a little bit. It's so soft and tender. It's unbelievable. But get a little bite here that has some sauce and maybe a little spaghetti. I don't know if I want that string hanging from my mouth. We'll skip that spaghetti. I've got a little here. This tastes good. And it's really so easy. And it is an Americanized version of the real thing. But it's I think, convenient for you. You can do it if you work and you want to have something a little different for supper. Tastes so good. I think you'll like it.